गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन। सो अगेन आफ्टर फिजिकल क्लासेस अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू ऑनलाइन क्लासेस बिकॉज एज यू नो दैट कोविड हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट यू आर अलाउड टू स्टे एट होम दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव स्टार्टेड ऑनलाइन क्लास अगेन। सो इट इज वन ऑफ द प्रोसेस दिस ईयर विच हैव बीन installed by our government to do the online classes, and the school also instructed to do the online classes regularly. That's why this is again a must that we should do online classes so that we can see that we can finish up the syllabus of 9th standard, and so you will be going to the 10th standard. Some of the concepts are required which is essential for the 10th also. That's why the online classes are necessary. So already we have finished some of the chapters in online classes, and some of the classes in physical classes we have already finished off. So today let us start a new lesson, that is work and energy. In this chapter we are going to study about work. How will you define work? What is work? So when a work is done, what condition work is done means at what condition the work is done, that we are going to study. Then we are going to study about energy, definition of energy, then types of energy. In that we are going to study about kinetic energy, then potential energy, then conservation of energy, law of conservation of energy. Then we are going to study about power and equation of power. So this is the last concept of the lesson. So before going to the depth of the lesson, see, as you know that we do lot of work at home. We carry some luggages. We will run, walk. We will sit and think. Thinking also need energy. When you are concentrating on something, you need energy. Basically, this chapter tells about the mainly it focus on energy, types of energy, but apart from this work. So work is what then? So work is a one of the physical quantity which happens due to energy, So work is a physical quantity which needs energy. Understood? So what is work? It's a physical quantity which needs energy. So I'm rubbing this. So we'll focus on the work. So work needs energy. So we can do any work by the help of energy. And what is energy then? Energy means what? Energy is capacity to do any work. So for a work, we need energy. Without energy, we cannot do any work. So lifting a table, lifting any object which is heavy, having heavy mass on the head, or coolie, coolie, he will have the luggage on his head. So he needs energy, muscular energy he needs. So a bulb provides a light. So that needs electrical energy. Electrical energy is converted into light energy. Understood? Photosynthesis. So during the photosynthesis, energy is produced. What type of energy? Food energy. See, for all energies, the sun is ultimate source of energy. Sun is ultimate source of energy. All energy just they are converted from. So sun ultimate source of energy is sun. From the sun, so photosynthesis happens because of the sunlight. So food energy is produced. See, food energy is converted to muscular energy. Similarly, wind energy is also indirect form of solar energy. Wind energy is the indirect form of solar energy because of the sunlight only wind is produced. Wind will produce. That's why we tell that wind energy is also one of the indirect source of solar energy. Understood? So at what condition we tell that work is done? At what condition we tell work is done? See, work is done. See, people tell work is done when, see, scientifically, work is when you apply a force on some object. When you apply a force on some object, if it displaces for a distance, then it is said to be that work is done. Scientifically, we can say that the work is done when force is applied. Two factors on which work is done, we tell that work is done. That is, force is applied. For a work to be done, the force should be applied. Understood? So, like that one more. Displacement of object. If these two happens, then we tell that work is done. So, to do work, we need some force, some energy. So force, if force is applied, then work is done. When displacement of the object has to happen, like this is the table. Okay, this is the table. You are keeping an object here. Object. And you are putting a force here. Say, what I told. At what condition the work is done? The work is done under the when the force is applied. And if the object displaces its position, or if the object displaces, then we tell that work is done. See here. So object is here on the table. We are putting a force over here. I am just pushing this. I am applying a force. And after some time, it will come to this position. So A position. This is A position. This is B position. The object is moving from this, from here to here. See, when I put the force, the displacement happened. So then we tell that work is done. Work is done. Without the displacement, we cannot tell that work is done. So scientifically, work done is nothing but when a force is applied, if the object displaces to some distance, then the work is done. That is about the work. Scientifically, work can be defined like this. Understood? Like, see, table is there. You are pushing the table. So table has displaced to one position. Then work is done. Understood? You are lifting any object from the bottom, from the floor, and lifting it, then work is done. Understood? So, like that way, we can tell that work is done. So what is the equations equation for the work done? What is the equation for the work done? So equation for work done is W is equal to F into S. See it. W means work done. W means work done. We can call it as work done. So how work is done? We apply a force. We apply a force. So F is force applied. Then S tells about displacement of object. So if force is applied, if a force is applied on object A, object, it displaces from position A to position B. Then we tell that work is done. Already you know it. So this is the equation for the work. Equation for the work. W is equal to F into S. This you should remember. This is necessary for the numericals which are present in exercise. So on this basis we solve it. So see, as you know that what is the SI unit of force? We already studied in Newton's force and Newton's law of motion. The unit of force is Newton. Unit of force is Newton. And what is the SI unit of displacement? That also we studied in motion chapter. Unit of displacement is what? Meter. Displacement is meter. Understood? So we tell that work done is equal to Newton meter. We tell that Newton meter. Understood? So Newton meter meter. So see, as you know that equation of work done is what? Force into displacement. When force is applied, the object displaces from its position to the new position. That's why we tell that work is done. Work is done. For that, it is the equation, and the SI unit of work done is meter per Newton meter. Newton meter. Which can be called as joule. Understood? Which can be called as joule. So what do you mean by one joule? One joule means what then? One joule means what? So this type of question can be asked. Like, what do you mean by one joule? One joule means what? So one joule means if one Newton force is applied on the object, if it displaces 1 unit length or 1 meter, it's called one joule. Understood? So W is equal to F into S. So when it is called this, joule is equal to the thing but Newton meter. Means one joule is nothing but if 1 newton of force is applied, and if displaces, if it displaces 1 meter, then we call it as 1 joule. 1 joule. On this, some of the numericals are given. Just we solve it. For an example, we'll do it. So, which is present in your exercise. So, the first question of the exercise. First question of the exercise. We'll solve it. See, a force of 7 newton act on an object. A force of 7 newton act on an object. The displacement is, say, about 8 meters in the direction of the force. Let us take the force act on an object through the displacement. What is the work done? So, what is the data given here? Data given is, they are given the force, how much? 8 newton force, sorry, 7 newton force, then displacement is 8 meter. So W is equal to F into S. So 7 newton, so force is given into 8. So this 56 joule of work is done when 7 newton of force is applied on an object. So this type of numericals is given in the textbooks. Just go through that. Is it clear? So some of the problems are given here. You take it as homework. So same type of question is given in page number 149. Calculate it. Page number 149. They have given one example, similar example. Go through that. Understood? So we have done one numerical on W is equal to F into S. We will see the next, that is here. The object is here. Object, a force is applied. And it displaces. This is the initial position. This is final position. See, this is the direction of the force, and object displacement happens here. When the force and the displacement are in the same direction, the work done is positive. Understood? Similarly, the force is acting like this. Force is acting in this direction and displacement happening in this direction, opposite direction. So in case of, say, I'll give an example, like when we are moving in a boat, we are applying a force on water in this direction. So see, a boat. Person is that. He is putting the force on this direction. And displacement is happening this direction. Opposite to the force. A person is putting the force on this direction. So, and the displacement is happening here. then it is called as negative. The work done is negative. Called as negative. Some situation there work is not done. We tell that work is not done. Some situation. I told you example like coolie. A person who carries a luggage on his head is called as coolie. So baggage or any load is kept on it. The person is moving. The person is moving. The force is acting downward. See, the force is acting. Force is acting downward. The force is acting downward. So see here, and the person is moving like this. The force is acting perpendicular to the surface, you tell them. So that time the work is said to be not to be done. Work is not to be done. Not to be done. You tell that work is not done. Work is not done because the force displacement and the force acting on the object is opposite. It's perpendicular to each other. Then we tell that work is not done. Work is not done. Understood? This is how we live. We tell that work is done or not done, or work is positive, work is negative. So such type of similar questions on this, some questions are asked in the exercise or in text question. Please go through that. If you have any doubt, you can just contact me through the WhatsApp. So this is about the work. So till now we have studied about work and what are the condition required for the work done, and what is positive work, negative work, and zero work. That we have finished. So next part of the lesson, we are moving to the energy part. Energy part. We are moving to the energy part. Already we have discussed what is energy. Energy is a capacity to do any work. Any work. So there are lot of energy, like electric energy, there solar energy, there wind energy, there nuclear energy is there, muscular energy is there, potential energy is there, kinetic energy is there. So all these energy required for doing some work. Without energy we cannot do any work. That is only called as energy. Capacity, a person capacity to do any work. A person do any work. A woodcutter or woodpecker, you know, it is a bird which will peck the wood. So there it does the work. It will hit the wood repeatedly till it will hit the wood till it has energy. Understood? We cut wood by axe is used to cut the wood. So till how much energy we have, we just cut. Like that, energy is a capacity to do any work. I told you already, thinking also needs energy. But in this chapter, we are going to mainly concentrate on kinetic energy and potential energy. So already you know, SI unit of energy was what? Joule. Joule is the SI unit of energy. Understood? So SI unit of energy is joule. We'll come across. So what is kinetic energy? See, you know, kinetic motion. See, air. As you know that air is also one of the matter. So air is a matter in which the molecules are loosely arranged. There is a lot of space between the molecule. That's why they move. They move. That is what we call as kinetic motion. Kinetic motion. So ability of molecules to move, that is called as a kinetic motion. Similarly, kinetic energy. Kinetic energy refers to what? So, see, like a moving object will have certain energy. Certain energy. Understood? So, moving air or blowing air is called wind. So, wind has energy. What energy? Kinetic energy. What energy wind is having? Wind is having kinetic energy. Why wind is formed? Because of sunlight, temperature variation in the atmosphere. Because of temperature variation in the atmosphere, wind is formed. So, wind is having a kinetic energy. Then, what do you mean by kinetic energy? So, kinetic energy is the energy which is possessed by an object due to its motion. Energy possessed by the body due to its motion is called kinetic energy. Kinetic energy. Understood. So energy possessed by the body due to its motion, due to virtue of its motion. Whenever a moving object will have kinetic energy. See, yes, like flow. Example, you can give flowing water, blowing wind. Rolling stone. So all these have energy. Understood? So this is an example for the kinetic energy. So meeting is going to end. So with this, we will stop for today. So we'll see the equation of kinetic energy, that is Ke is equal to half mv square in the next class. And we'll derive this equation. There is a derivation of this equation. So we'll do it in the next class. Thank you very much. Till then. Thank you.